Hi. In this video, we are going to talk about how to launch a preset using the Mecha user interface and how to create and save your own presets for panoramic photography. First, please watch one of our videos on accessing the Mecha user interface, then come back to this video. On the row page, top left, notice the info button. Click on it when you need more information about the controls available in the user interface. Hide this information using the same button. The list next to the info button contains options for setting the complexity level for the user interface. The letter A stands for advanced, and S, for simple. So select the A3 option to see all the controls in the user interface. In the preset list, there are factory presets ready to use for different types of panoramas. Note that some factory presets contain the terms parked, level or raised in their name. Let's see what they mean. In dual-axis applications, the upper rail of the pano head must be in one of these positions when launching a preset. So before launching the preset, make sure that the upper rail is in the position required by the preset, and test Mecha without a camera mounted first. Parked, the most compact position, the upper rail is oriented vertically down. Level, the upper rail is in the horizontal position. Raised, the opposite of parked, the upper rail is oriented vertically upwards. Let's go back to the user interface and launch TEST1312 Parked. First, select the preset, then load it by clicking the Load button. Depending on the user interface complexity level, the Load button may not be visible, and in this case, when selecting a preset, it is loaded as well. Position the upper rail in the parked position using the arrow buttons on the controller. To execute the loaded preset, either click the left button if you want it to be executed to the left, or the right button to be executed to the right. There will be 12 shots around, 3 rows, 1 at a tilt of 0 degrees, no tilt, 1 at plus 45 degrees and 1 at minus 45 degrees, plus zenith and nadir. You can use the pause button if you need a temporary pause during the execution of the preset. Then use the same button to continue. Notice that the feedback from Mecha continues as well. Both the stop button in the user interface and the power button on the controller can be used as an emergency stop, if needed. TEST1312 Parked is a factory preset and you can't override it. Instead, you can use it as a template to create your own preset. Instead of 12 shots, you can select the desired number from the list, or you can specify the focal length using the custom option, and Mecha will generate a ready-to-use script for that focal length. Notice how the rotation angle changes according to the number of shots, so that if we multiply the two values, the result is 360 degrees. TRG is the number of camera triggerings in each position. AF, autofocus. Select MF from the list if you use manual focus on your camera. W, the pause for camera wake up. B, the pause before a set of images. M, the modifier of exposure. 1 means no change in exposure. E, in short, E is the exposure. Normally, you set the exposure on your camera. This is the duration of the shutter button signal, and the value should be at least equal to the exposure set on the camera, or higher. When using the camera's bulb mode, Mecha can control the exposure, and the value set here is the actual exposure. Due to camera's limitations, the exposure in bulb mode is suitable for 1 second or longer. A is the delay after each bracketing sequence or individual image. The rotation angle between two consecutive positions in a sequence, specified for NX left or NX right button. The rotation angle is updated automatically when the number of shots is changed. However, If the rotation angle is changed, the number of shots does not change. Use this feature when you want to take a certain number of shots, not an entire panorama. Specify this number in the next field, XN, and execute the sequence with the NX left or NX right button. Wait alternates with rewind. These options tell Mecha to wait after the last shot, or to rewind to the initial position. Rewind is useful if there are cables attached, or for partial panorama and time lapse. Repeat is the delay, until the shooting sequence will be repeated automatically. This is the MSS, or Mecha Simple Scripting, script that describes the preset, and Mecha automatically creates it. Please note that the script can be edited and takes priority over the settings we have talked about so far without changing them. The script can contain both single or dual axis commands. On the other hand, if you select single, for single Mecha applications, or dual, for dual Mecha applications, only the preset settings are considered. This is the speed in revolutions per minute. You step, micro stepping value, simple or combined, for example, different values for accelerated and constant speed regions. Now let's change some settings and save the preset with a different name. For example, 8 shots instead of 12. A delay of 2 seconds after each shot. And rewind instead of wait. And, also, 8 shots instead of 12 in script, as the script takes priority over the other settings. Click the Save button to save the preset. Enter a name. And click the OK button. You can add a short description or leave this field blank, and click OK again. The preset has been added to the list and you can use it whenever you need it. A preset for dual-axis applications can be executed by Mecha single-axis as well. In this case, Mecha signals that you need to manually tilt the pan ahead by turning on some LEDs. It also displays, on its LEDs, how many degrees the tilt should be, and continue executing the preset only after you tilt the pan ahead. Thank you for watching.